Welcome. In the video on sustainable energy, the following question was raised. If you know at any time the amount of power that you use at your home, how can you determine your daily energy consumption? In this video, I will show you how to answer this question using integration. Let's say we want to calculate the total energy consumption between time equal to A and time equal to B. If the power is constant during that interval, then the total energy consumption is simply the power P times the length of the interval, P minus A. But in general, the power will not be constant. What can we do? The idea is the following. First, divide the time interval into small subintervals, each of length delta T. Now we pretend that on every such interval, the power is constant. This is of course not true, but if the subintervals are small, then at least the power will not vary too much. We can then estimate the energy consumption per subinterval. Let's zoom in on one of the subintervals to make this more precise. First, we choose a time in the interval. Let's call it T3 because we're in the third subinterval. Then we pretend that on this interval, the power is constant and equal to the power at time T3. This is an approximation. The real energy consumption on this interval is then approximately equal to P of T3 times delta T. We can represent this product graphically by the area of a rectangle with base delta T and height P of T3, as shown in the picture. This we can repeat for each interval. Choose a point and approximate the energy consumption. The total energy consumption is then approximated by the sum of all contributions, PT1 times delta T plus PT2 times delta T, etc. We can use the summation sign to denote this sum more compactly. Here, n is the number of subintervals, in this case, 5. The sum can be graphically represented by the total area of the rectangles. Of course, this is still an approximation. The power is not constant on every interval. But to make the approximation better, we can repeat the whole procedure for a larger number n of subintervals, each with smaller length delta t. In the limit that n goes to infinity and delta t goes to zero, we will obtain the exact energy consumption. This number also has a geometric meaning. In this case, it is the total area between the graph of the function p and the interval from A to B on the horizontal axis. This process of taking the limit of sums of smaller and smaller intervals is called integration. The sums that we wrote down to approximate the total energy consumption are called Riemann sums. They are named after their inventor, the famous 19th century mathematician Bernard Riemann. In the limit of the Riemann sums as the size of the delta t's goes to zero is called the integral of the function on the given interval. In this case, we can say that the total energy consumption is equal to the integral of the function pt for t ranging from t equal to a to t equal to b. We denote it as follows. The integral is denoted as a stretched S. The interval boundaries go below and above this sign, and it is followed by the function pt and ended with dt. You can think of the dt as a limit of the delta t's. This process is not limited to the context above. Let's look at a function f depending on a variable x. We wish to define the following object, the integral of f of x for x ranging from x equal to a to x equal to b. Let us run through the procedure again. First, we break up the interval into a number of subintervals of length delta x. Then we choose points with x-coordinate x1, x2, etc., one in each subinterval. These points are called sample points. Given a subdivision and the sample points, we can write the Riemann sum. The sum here represents the total area of a number of rectangles. Now we repeat this for increasing number n of intervals with decreasing length delta x. If the limit exists, independent of how we choose the sample points, then the number we obtain is by definition the integral of fx for x ranging from a to b. In this case, the number represents the area of the region between the graph and the interval from a to b on the horizontal axis. I say specifically in this case, In general, you have to be careful with this interpretation. More about that in the next video. To end, let us return to the original question, how to determine energy consumption on a given time interval, provided you know power as a function of time. The answer is, evaluate the integral of this function on the given time interval. I have to be honest here, in practice it is often impossible to evaluate such an integral exactly, but in many cases it suffices to have an approximation. To make such an approximation, you can use a Riemann sum. In fact, this is roughly what a digital electricity meter does. It measures the power at sample points in time and then calculates a Riemann sum to approximate the total energy consumption. What if you do want to evaluate an integral exactly? Taking the limit of Riemann sums can be very cumbersome or even impossible. Luckily, there is a way to circumvent taking limits. More about this in the following subsection. But first, let's practice with the concept.